Now, FL Studio is one of those unique DAWs that has a step sequencer built into the channel rack. This step sequencer can be used to create drum patterns very easily. And in this lesson, we're going to take a look at how we can create a variety of different drum patterns using the step sequencer. Let's now take a look at how we can make use of the step sequencer that's available in the channel rack to create a drum pattern. Now, as I've mentioned before, everything revolves around patterns. You can see over here, pattern one is selected. And if I create a new pattern for the drums, that pattern will be inside this pattern number one. So let's rename this. I click over here and select rename and color. I'll call it drum one. I can click over here to select a color for this pattern. Let's say this dark olive green, hit accept, hit enter. And now you can see the pattern has been renamed. And in the playlist, in the pattern picker specifically, we also see that pattern. All right, now let's use the step sequencer. So the step sequencer has individual steps here that represents a 16th note. So this is an entire bar. I can click to add hits for that particular sound. To delete a hit, I can right-click the existing hit and that will be removed. So left-click to add a hit and right-click to delete a hit. I'm going to change the tempo over here, bring it down to 120 BPM. Another way to change tempo is to click over here to open the tempo tapper, and I can just tap with the mouse to set the tempo that I would like to play back at. So I settle in on 121, and you can see here this has changed to 121. And now, as long as pattern is selected, and if I hit play, we will hear the kick pattern. Let's add on to this. Add a clap here, another clap here. Snare the same position. I can right-click over here and choose fill each two steps to quickly fill in a pattern for that specific channel. All right, so that is a pattern that I've created using the step sequencer in the channel rack. I can further tweak this pattern. So for example, if I want those hi-hats to have different volume or velocity, if I click over here, I can open the graph editor. You can see here the hi-hat channel is selected. And now these sliders here represents the velocity for the individual hits. I can bring it down to make it quieter, move it up to make it louder. Let's have a listen to this. I want to make the snare quieter. We can also change the pitch for the individual hits. So right now everything is in this default C5, but I can click and drag upwards or downwards to change the pitch. And I can even click and drag like this to add individual hits and get this very nice melodic style hi-hat pattern. All right, so that is one pattern. I click this plus button here to create a new pattern. Let's call this drum two. Let's give this a different color. Accept and hit enter. Now we have a new pattern selected here. A new pattern appears here in the pattern picker. Everything's cleared out over here. And now we can create a new pattern. Now for the second pattern, I want to use a different sound. So let's open up the browser and look for a different sample. In the search here, I'm going to type in what I'm looking for. So I'm looking for a shaker. So as soon as I type in shaker, anything in the library that has the name shaker appears. So I can preview any of these sounds by just clicking. I like this one, Attack Shaker 09. So if I would like to use this, I can just click and drag and drop it right below the 808 snare track. So now I have a fifth channel in my channel rack. You may notice that we don't have a number for the new shaker sample. This is the target mixer track number. So by default, these four sounds are going into individual inserts on the mixer. But the new sample that I added is not connected to any mixer insert. So if I click and drag here, I can manually make that connection. So I've set it to mixer insert number 5. So if I was to play the sound,
it will now go into mixer insert number 5. All right, let's close out the mixer. And now let's create a new pattern, including that shaker. And there we have it. Now we have a new pattern with a new sound. Now if I click and drag over here to switch to the first pattern, we still have this fifth sound over here. We're just not using it in the first pattern. Switching over to the second one, this includes the shaker. Alright, so that's how you can create drum patterns using the step sequencer on the channel rack.